In this video, we're going to be solving two problems, and one is to identify the chiral centers in the compound you see on the screen. And two is to determine how many stereoisomers are possible for that same compound. So before we do this, I just want to explain what chiral centers are. Chiral centers are atoms that we contain four different groups, or that has four different groups attached to it. So what we are going to be looking out for the question one is to look out for atoms that have four different groups on them. Okay, and before we do that, I would like us to expand some of these things, put the lone pairs on oxygen because they count too, and also on the nitrogens. Okay, so now we're ready to start. So I'm going to start from this compound here, this C. Now, look at the C has three hydrogen. That shows us that it's not what we're looking for, right? Because it already has three hydrogen and not different. So it's just going to have about two different type of groups attached to it. That's hydrogen and one other thing. And same thing applies to this one here. So these two are out of the question. Now, this one here has two lone pairs, which is seen as the same. So it's also out of the question. Then for a benzene ring, because of the double bond, they also do not qualify to have chiral centers because each of these carbons will be having three groups attached to them. It could be same groups or different. So it would not be able to have four different groups attached to it. So we don't have to bother ourselves with that first part. Now let's come here. For this carbon here, or for this atom here, which is a carbon, you have OH attached and you have a CH3. Now, these two are two different things. Now, when we come here, we see that this part attached to this part here, you have a C here, another C here. So you have like a double bond C attached here. And here you have a straight chain, like a C attached to another C, but no double bond, right? So that shows us that those are two different groups. Now, this group will count as one, this will count as two, we have this as three, we have this as four, and this qualifies to be a chiral center. So this will be one chiral center. Now, let's go ahead. Here, I'm going to wipe that too away. So for this compound here, we have a hydrogen which was not written out. So we have one hydrogen, we have another group. Now look at this group, it's attached to a CH3, right? And OH, and then there's another C here. And then this side, you have a C with two H. So looking at these two, you see that those are two different groups, okay? And plus the H, you have three different groups. And then you come up here, there's a C here attached to a carbonyl group, attached to it, to another carbon with OH group, totally different from what we have down here. So this also qualifies to be a chiral center. Then when we go up here, this double bond also makes it impossible for this carbon atom here to have four different groups. So this also does not qualify because you're going to have one group here and another group here. And then, of course, the oxygen, which is three different groups and not four. And then this oxygen here has two lone pairs, which is the same. So it can only have two other groups. And then these two lone pairs has already disqualified it because two lone pairs are considered as the same group. So it doesn't have four different groups. So that is not part of what we're looking for. Here, same rules that, you know, what we said here, that double bonds has made it impossible, and just like you said here too, for more carbons, more groups to be attached. So you can only have three groups attached to this. Now you have here, you have one carbon here attached to this, and then attached to this one, and then here. So that's three and not four. So this center here is not part of what we are looking for. The same thing goes here too, because this carbon, this double bond is also affecting that carbon. So it wouldn't also be part of what we're looking for, right? And then oxygen, same thing, two lone pairs, same group. So it's out of the question. Now let's come down here. We have this one here attached to this group and attached to this group. Of course, those are different groups, but then we have the same group under, which makes it not possible, right, to be a chiral center. So we move to this other one here. We have one hydrogen, another group. This set of group is obviously different from this set of group because you have a carbon attached to H2, and this other carbon at this end is attached to nitrogen. And then this other carbon up here is attached to H and another C with O and another C with, you know, a double bond O, which is obviously different from what we have done here. So this is a chiral center because now we have one at the up, then we have two at this end, and we have three at this end, plus this hydrogen making it four. So we have a chiral center here. Now we've come up here. We have hydrogen, which is one group. We have this carbon with the OH, which is two. We have the double bond with this three. This with the CH is four, right? So this is a chiral center because it has four different groups attached to it. So that is a chiral center. So, yeah. Now let's check this one out. This has N here with a methyl group, two methyl groups, and it has all of these attached to it, which is obviously different from this carbon with just one OH. So we have a one here, a two here, and a three at this end. And then there is a hydrogen, which was not written out. So we have to be careful because carbon has to be attached to four different things. It could be atoms, or it could be bonds and all that. So it has to be complete. The octet has to be complete. Okay, so this qualifies to be a chiral center. Okay, then here, same thing we've been seeing all over here. It's disqualified because of it has same group of lone pairs. Then here, because of the double bond, is already disqualified. Same applies with this one up here. Same thing with this one up here. And the nitrogen here has two hydrogens, which already tells us that it can have four. Okay, although the lone pair and this is different, but he has two that are the same. So he does not have four different groups. Now that we are done with each of these groups here, we then count. We have one, two, three, four, five. And that solves the problem number one. So we have five chiral centers. Okay. And then for number two, it says how many stereoisomers are possible. And to solve that, we use a formula, which is 2n. Okay, so number of stereoisomer, which I'm going to represent as x, will be equals to 2 raised to power n. Your n is equals to number of chiral centers, okay, which is what we already got now. So to solve for x, we will have 2 raised to power 5, which is same thing as saying 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. Okay, that's if you do not have a calculator to do that, this is the same as this. Okay, okay, so that will give us a 32. So there are 32 possible stereoisomers in this compound. This is the end of the video. Thank you for watching, and please don't forget to subscribe.